Okay. Welcome. In this module, I'd like to briefly introduce you to the field of environmental education and education for sustainable development. It's a short historical review of those fields. Let me start right away. I think it is fair to say that in many countries across the globe, we already can see nature conservation education emerge about 100 years ago. In the United States, for instance, in 1872, the National Park of Yellowstone was already created and the national park system was formed. But also in countries like India, the first national park was founded in 1932. And mainly the aim was to connect people with nature, biodiversity, and help them develop a better understanding of the web of life and the importance of ecology. Even in urban areas and in cities like in the Netherlands already in 1919, some cities created school garden programs for children who never got to leave the city, but the government felt it was important that they too got to understand where food came from and got to understand the importance of nature. So nature conservation education can be seen as a predecessor of environmental education. If we move to the middle of this slide and we see these smokestacks symbolizing a change in the quality of the physical environment that already started happening in the industrial times, air pollution, water pollution, pollution of soils, leading to a concern about the future quality of life on the planet as people as populations were growing. The Limits to Growth report by the Club of Rome in 1972 was kind of warning us that we should change the way we live on the planet. At that time, environmental education became more prominent, not just focusing on connecting people with nature, but helping them understand their own environmental behavior and helping them engaged in reducing waste, recycling programs, reducing energy use, and also engaging school children in monitoring and measuring changes in water quality, air pollution, and so on. Environmental education was mainly focusing on changing behavior, changing environmental behavior, and was seen as one of the instruments alongside of policy, fiscal instruments, but also law and legislation. Although within environmental education, there was also a group that did not want to focus so much on changing behavior, but helping people think critically about their relation with the environment. If you move to the right of this slide, we see a picture that is from Katrina, post-Katrina, the big hurricane that hit New Orleans. And it symbolizes the sustainable development issue, where people in 1992 gathered at the Earth Summit in Rio de Janeiro and started talking not just about ecology and environment, but also about economics and issues of equity, fairness, and poverty, the local connected to the global, for instance. Things like climate change started emerging as a global systemic problem that needed a response from governments, from industry, but certainly also from education. And in Agenda 21 and Chapter 36 at the Rio Summit, environmental education, or sustainability education rather, was mentioned as a key tool. These are some of the examples, you could say, that are connected to nature conservation education. A lot of place-based education, connecting children, young people in particular, with natural environment and understanding the web of life. These kinds of pictures are more related to environmental education, looking at waste, looking at recycling, connecting people with environmental issues, also through monitoring. And you could say that these kinds of pictures where we take a more holistic, systemic approach to deal with, this is from the Millennium Assessment, Ecosystem Assessment Report, where it's not just looking at ecosystem services, but also at the constituents of well-being, looking also at poverty and equity, and trying to gather people in more multi-stakeholder environments where we try to understand from different perspectives how to live more lightly on the planet with people and planet in mind. Now, across the world there are different relationships between environmental education, nature conservation education, NE in this slide, and ESD education for sustainable development. You could say in some parts the nature education and the ecological literacy and connection to nature is seen as critical, but it is smaller than environmental education, which also adds the environmental layer, and it's smaller again than education for sustainable development because that also includes social justice issues and economic issues. So this is kind of how they sit together. There are also those who think that environmental education, in the spirit of UNESCO, UNEP's conference of Tbilisi in 1977, is already covering all these issues anyway. So ESD is a part of environmental education and nature conservation education is a part of that. In other parts of the world, there's an overlap between environmental education and ESD, and nature conservation education is mostly connected to environmental education. But they're different, but there's overlap. And again, in other countries, in other discourses, you could say, you could argue that ESD is just a phase in the evolution of nature conservation education, and something else will be coming next. We don't even know what it might be called today. So it's a stage in the evolution of education. And fourth one would be to say that environmental education and ESD are basically the same thing, but politically ESD might be more popular among governments. So we pragmatically use ESD, but really we're talking about EE still. Another way of looking at the relationship between environmental education and ESD is to say that both have narrow interpretations, mostly focusing on the ecological and the environment, but there are also broader, more inclusive interpretations where the socio-cultural and the political also are part of the education. And if that's the case, they kind of merge at the top when they're broadly interpreted, or they merge at the bottom when they're narrowly interpreted. So if you would say, how do we summarize this very quickly? Nature conservation education, mainly between the 1900s and 1970s, although making a comeback today, I must say. Many cities and countries are focusing more and more on green areas, green schoolyards, place-based education. So it's making a comeback, recognizing how important it is to connect with plants, animals, and ecosystems. Environmental education and communication, you could say, mainly between 1970 and 1992, a focus also and mostly on environmental behavior, not just looking at children but also adults, looking at environmental education centers in cities, environmental campaigning, and education for sustainable development, you could say, started in 1992, is focusing more on issues of the North and the South, issues of equity, fairness, but also looking for more systemic changes in the way we live, dealing with what we call in this course wicked problems, issues that cannot be easily defined but are very urgent, like climate change and loss of food security. And running through the history of environmental education and education for sustainability, there's this tension between what we might call the instrumental approach, trying to change people's behavior in a predetermined, pre-described way, versus an emancipatory approach, where it's more about capacity building, enabling people to make up their own minds, to develop their own values, and to emphasize high quality interaction between different stakeholders, trying to co-create a more sustainable world, of which we do not know exactly what it might look like, but we do know that we need to engage people meaningfully in the search for such a world. Now, this will be hard to read, but this is a definition, you could say, of sustainability education. And what is interesting about this definition is that I've taken the Tbilisi Declaration on Environment Education definition from 1977, and all I did was I with using find and replace in Word, replaced environmental education with sustainability education, and you will see that it's a remarkably inclusive and I would say accurate description of what many educators around the world seeking to harmonize people and planet are trying to accomplish. This is the kind of description that I think will be helpful in this course, and looking at education for sustainability in this way can be very powerful and helpful in addressing wicked sustainability problems.